God damn it. It's been a long couple days. Your boy is tired. Your boy has been doing a lot of shit. And yeah, been a long couple days. But you know how it is. Welcome back to Cut the Fuck Out Podcast. I am your narcissistic host, AC. And this is where we are now. I have a special guest in the building with me today. We got Wells sitting in the building today. What's going on, sir?
Yo, 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 it's your boy Wells, a.k.a. DJ Dick 'em Down. And this is one message for all the haters and hoes. Suck it slow, suck it slow.
All right, I got to turn your volume up now. Now, what the hell just happened there? Talking to the mic a little closer.
You took my volume away.
Oh, there we go. That's what I need to do right there. Let me add some gains back to you real quick.
Yeah, he took my voice away.
All right. There we go. Now we got him back now. Okay. Where we want to start here? Weekend recap. My weekend was very eventful. Very fucking eventful. Uh-oh. Let me see. What, class reunion was Friday. That was fun. That was a lot of fun. Saturday, my mom's place, they had a pool party at my mom's place. Invited some people out there. Went to the pool party over there. DJ, drinks are flowing. Brought my little brother out there. I don't know what it is, but big girls like my little brother. They like skinny niggas, I guess.
Big girls do like skinny dudes.
Yeah.
That's a known fact.
So he pulled a couple different ones. But we got back to my crib, and I said, you know what? Everybody said they texted me, said they at the pool. So I said, fuck it. Let's go down to the pool. Went down to the pool. Little did I know, he invited one of the big girls over. This podcast is called Cut the Fuck Out. So we about to get into it.
Because I have a problem with this story, Anthron.
What's the problem you have, Will?
Go ahead and tell the story and I'll tell you what my problem is.
Hey, so we got to the pool. We have all done it having fun. Got back up to the apartment. And one thing led to another, and I end up giving her to Captain Morgan in the bathroom.
Cut it the fuck out. Cut it the fuck out. You have to tell the story. you said you weren't cutting corners. Cut it the fuck out.
So I walked in the bathroom. I was going to the bathroom, and she went to work. I will say this, big girls make love to the dick. They definitely make love to the dick, because she definitely did. And then she got into a freaky bag, and she said, I want to fuck both of y'all. Who am I to deny her the pleasure?
Of taking two. Fuck it. Sometimes you got to take two, I guess. Pause.
Emotional damage.
Oh man. That was Saturday. Sunday.
No, you didn't finish the story.
I can't finish it that way because I don't wanna.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, I know my little brother. I love him to death.
Shout out to his little brother.
Yeah, I ain't gonna say anything.
Don't do it again.
Yeah. Oh man.
We'll leave it at that.
Yeah, so Sunday was chill. Monday, I didn't decide to do it again. Monday is when some shit got, you know what? Let's get into this pod real quick. Hold on. We can't get in this story yet. Gotta get into the pod first. Before we get into all the other stuff, I gotta say some sad shit that I didn't want to say, but I have to. It has been a lot of fun, but the last 5 days has been a lot of deaths around me that I don't like at all. My cousin, one of our childhood friends, he overdosed. He overdosed on fentanyl, and he died. They found him dead. And then
we're about to smoke through the whole podcast.
And then one of my best friends, Michael Richardson, he was murdered. Army vet, did his time. PTSD kicked in. He went through a rough patch. And somebody walked up to his tent and shot it up, beat him up as well, and killed him. And then a guy that I look up to, cool dude, it's always been cool. They found him dead in his living room. So it's been a lot of fun and games, but also it's been a lot of shit that I don't want to deal with. Didn't want to deal with, but it's life.
Hey,
it's life, and shit happens. So, yeah, that's the sad shit I didn't want to get into.
RIP to the people.
Yeah, let me get into it this way.
Outstanding. One of them be off mute. You got me off.
They're trying to play the content or what? I ain't gonna say nothing. You make me wanna shout. Yeah, you look sweet tonight.
Say what? Wish
that I could love you.
If they send me your number, they're gonna call you on the podcast.
In a special way, girl.
RIP, RIP to the people.
Send it to the chat, this chat.
No.
Yeah, or you can send it to Anthony personally.
Tell her to DM me. Don't send it to the chat.
All right, wherever he gonna see it at. I'm gonna send it to Thrawny ass. You feel me?
Thrawny.
Thrawny.
We definitely it's I gotta turn it.
Man, you could imagine. That's funny.
That one down right there. Is that on the recording? I think that may have been on a recording.
Might have to start this episode over.
Yeah, that might be a recording right there. No, I think I muted it, but I think it's still on there.
I don't think so, because it was definitely loud.
Yeah, that was definitely loud right there. It's in my headphones too. All right, let's get into the pod. I don't want to bring this pod in. Let me bring the pod in this way.
I'm
down here. We out in these streets right now. We out in these streets real quick. Let's go.
Inside, outside.
Where you at?
Inside, but outside.
Oh, inside, outside. Let me go here. This is our old boy, Philip Dylan.
Oh, man. Oh, what this said, guys, too.
It's kind of crazy, babe, how I remember things like where you came from and how you had nothing. I went and made you fly, put extras on your ride. Didn't miss a birthday, now you can't even remember mine. You wasn't down for me,
you made me blind, baby.
But now I see
you had things up your sleeve.
Oh, I even heard it from your family.
How could you let somebody lay where I lay? How could you give them everything that we made?
All right, y'all know I get in my R&B bag. You know I get in my R&B bag and just go a little crazy with it. All right, now do you want to get into yesterday?
Let's go.
So. People, I swear to you, I can't make this shit up. Wells is here.
Unfortunately. But I was here. So I can vouch for what he's saying.
Don't. Look, man. Only thing I can say is this. You should not let a girl who has a nice body like that take you to the pool. Cause
not when this motherfucker is around.
what are you saying, man?
Not when this motherfucker is around. This is the pool man. This is the pool man.
Yeah, so what we're talking about is this. We had a good time with the pool party. Yes, can we call it a pool party?
It wasn't really a party. It was just like motherfuckers was drinking at the pool.
Yeah, it was just motherfuckers drinking at the pool, and I invited a girl over. We were vibing out. We were having fun. She knew what she came here for. I knew what she came here for.
They knew what was going down.
Yeah, but at the pool, there was a girl who showed up, and some dude that she just met, she came over. She started having fun with us. One thing led to another, and the girl that I invited over, I asked them to the kiss, and they started kissing. And then it's back to the crib.
Hey, let me tell y'all something. I've never seen a motherfucker use champagne to his advantage more than this nigga here. This nigga uses champagne like a deadly weapon. Like, that's his fatality. If a bitch get sushi or champagne, she's out of there.
Yeah, that's...
She's out of there.
Hey. That is not on me, man.
Let me tell y'all something. He left out the fact that I was there. So I can tell y'all how shit kind of went a little bit.
I was trying to not say that yet and get involved in the whole thing, but you know what? It is Cut the Fuck Out podcast. Let's expose some shit real quick. That nigga shook his head at me. That nigga shook his head at me. Yo, man, it was definitely something that you actually had to be there
to witness.
Yeah, to witness. Like, that was
something I've never seen. A man see his girlfriend go to another man and another woman, and the man kiss her in front of him. and he didn't do nothing. And I'm sitting on the sideline like, this motherfucker has to be ready to fight. But nothing happened. Next thing I know, I said, hey, fam, I'm finna get ready to go. He was like, yeah, we finna head out too. Like, all right. So I see this nigga. I see him with the female he was with. I look out, when I get to my, all I know is when I was pulling out, I seen him and the two females, and the guy wasn't nowhere else to be found. Now, after that, I don't know what happened.
I didn't know that was going to happen that way. I didn't know it was going to happen that way, man.
That could have happened differently, but that was what I see.
Well, let's just say it this way. Let's just say it this way.
Nope. I'm a flirt. Soon as I see you walk up in the club, I'm a flirt.
Yep. See you walk in the pool. I'm a flirt. Watch your back.
With my chick on,
I'm a flirt.
And when she's with a man looking at me, damn right, I'm a flirt. So homie, don't bring your girl to eat. Baby, don't bring your girlfriend to eat, cause I'm a flirt. Please believe it, unless your game is tight and you trust her.
All right. Now we're back. That was a little technical difficulties. Had to figure some shit out for a second. You ready to get into topics now?
Let's do it.
Hey, man, we all have been talking our shit already, but I'm just trying to figure out what in the fuck happened last night. Like, that's that right there is, I haven't done anything like that since college.
How does it make you feel when you do it? But how does it make you feel knowing that you can still do it at your age now?
Oh man, it was. I need to slow down. Oh man.
Hey, shut up. Man, that's crazy.
Will's talking to your mic a little bit better, bro.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, there we go.
Yes,
there
sir.
We go.
I got you.
Oh man. That was fun right there. Now I will say this though, old girl, I think I'm still gonna fuck her too. She lives in an apartment complex.
Oh, yeah. So that becomes apartment pussy.
That's dangerous.
So you just got to be able to play, know the times. You got to know when she work, when the other ones, that you can't be just pulling everything from the pool now. You got to calm down a little bit. You're getting hot out here in these pools. You're getting hot out there in the street.
Said you're getting hot
in the pool. In phase one and phase two, you a motherfucker. Shit, anything. Every time I talk to you, Wells. Wells, I just came from the pool. Oh, here you go. That's what I'm saying. You did it.
I'm still trying to figure out why the elder girl wrote me a fucking novel. Like, calm the fuck down, man. We're not dating. I'm sure you're going to listen to this pod. You do it already, which I've never even known this shit. She said, I've seen you on IG Live a couple times.
Hey, so is this the podcast pussy you was telling us about?
No, I didn't. I now come to think about it, I think that this may be podcast pussy. I think she may have been podcast pussy the entire time. I never knew it, though. I didn't know, like I said, I didn't know she actually followed anything that I was doing. I didn't know she was watching the IG Live.
Hey, man.
I didn't know she listened to the pod.
You never know who's watching.
Oh, my God.
Moral of the story
is, hey, when you think somebody's not watching, they pretty much are.
Cut it the fuck out. Cut it the fuck out. Give them a show. If you're going to do it, put on the show. Fuck it.
Do it to the max.
You ain't got one life.
Hey, we're gonna do something a little fun right now. I got out of there.
Hey,
we're gonna do some phone calls. and have a blast with some people that we talk to all the time right here.
Real quick. Shout out to the weed man.
Shout out to the weed man.
Facts.
Did he give some good shit?
Always.
Shout out to the weed man.
Just so y'all know.
This nigga is smoking over here.
Who do we got on the line?
Hello.
Hey, can I speak to Hazel?
Yes, she.
Hazel, this is AC with Cut the Fuck Out Podcast. Sitting in today. Wells is sitting in with me. How are you doing, lady?
I'm doing good. Thanks for having me.
What's up, Hazel? She didn't even speak back. Ain't that a bitch?
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can. Yes, we can hear you, sweetheart.
Okay. What's up, guys?
Yes. So we're just sitting over here. We're just going through a topic of trying not to be what did you just say, Wells?
What's
up? He told me I was hot out here in these streets.
Yeah, he hot out here in these pool streets. In the pool phase one and phase two, you better leave your bitch from around that throne, because it ain't gonna happen. It's not gonna happen, I promise.
So, we got a question for you.
Okay.
All right. When's the last time that you just said, you know what? Fuck it. I'm about to do some nasty shit today.
Uh-oh.
When's the last time you just said, you know what? Let me blow his mind or her mind. Let me just do some nasty shit real quick.
Or her.
It's honestly been a while for me. It's been a while. But I would say probably like 6 to 8 months ago is the last time.
That's the last time you just okay. What did you do? Did you have that mindset before you got there or what?
Wait, what did you say?
So did you have that mindset before he got there or what?
Nah, I ain't had that mindset before he got there. It kind of just led to that. But this was also my partner, though, so it was just a situation where it was spontaneous, you know? And, yeah.
Hey, spontaneous sex is the best sex sometimes.
Let me ask, what level of nasty did you get?
I feel like y'all is calling the play. You know exactly what you would imagine. That's what went down.
Oh,
we had sex, guys. We had
my
sex.
Imagination.
We went hard. You know?
Imagination is a motherfucker, though.
I'm sorry.
My imagination is a motherfucker.
Yeah, so use it, because it was a spicy night.
Oh, damn.
It was a spicy night.
Spicy. Jalapeno or habanero?
What?
You said it was spicy, right? Jalapeno or habanero?
No, you know, like, not the hottest chili. Spicy in the world.
Look, or ghost chili.
Yeah, like the ghost pepper. Ghost pepper hot. Ghost pepper hot.
Okay.
We was doing all kind of crazy positions.
Oh. Oh, shit. All right. That may be like the one chip challenge. Shit.
Shout out to the one chip challenge.
Oh, no, that one Dominican chick that I had that came over there one day. That shit right there blew my mind. She was.
What did she do?
Oh, she was. She gave me that super head. That let me make it wet, crazy. Let me make me cry. Make tears come out of my eyes. Like,
oh, man.
What the?
Yeah, I almost
made a noise, but I noticed that I'm talking into a mic. Didn't feel like it would have been the right thing to do.
So,
right there.
Yeah. It was. Smacked me in the face with it. Like, oh yeah, she was going to work. I gotta appreciate her. I appreciated her. She does live in my apartment.
What were you smacked in the face with?
Huh?
What were you smacked in the face with?
What was I smacking her in the face with?
Oh, okay. I thought she was smacking you in the face with something.
Yo, now you just being rude.
No, no, no. I thought that's what you said.
No, I was. She was asking me to smack in the face of my penis, so that's what it was. You know.
Oh.
You know. If you had the kind of sex you said you just had, you were doing the same thing.
Somebody got slapped up a little bit.
Yeah, that's what I said. That's what she meant.
She meant that shit.
Yeah. Hey, we had to call you on the pod.
For sure.
I'm glad you just said what you said and like to have fun with it and roll with it. Now when I see you, what's up? You ready to get to Austin?
Oh shit.
I'm ready to get to Austin for sure. Like, it's gonna be lit. Between all of us being there, it's gonna be a lituation for sure.
Fact. Shout out to the lobby gang.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to have an epic fucking 4 days?
Four or five days
in September. If y'all see me out, just mind your fucking business.
Mind your business. That's funny.
All right, so we love you.
Gang. Thanks for having me, y'all.
No problem. Have a great day, lady. Hazel in a goddamn building,
hey,
man.
Hey, but real talk, if you're in H-Town, y'all look Hazel up, man. She be doing her hair. For real, she cold, too. Y'all look up.
Yeah, it's gonna be a blast right there with that one. Where we at now? Let's get into, how do you handle sneaky links? Huh. I'm not in a relationship, so I handle sneaky links the way I handle everything.
So let me ask you, how do you feel about being the sneaky link?
That is, I have absolutely no problem with that.
You're a certified side nigga.
I'm not in a relationship, so I don't give a damn.
Certified side nigga, that's crazy.
You know what's so crazy? Did you told me that you heard old boy say that? I didn't hear him say that yesterday. That if somebody was fucking this girl, he'd kill him.
Yeah, he was right there. But see, that's when you know they're intimidated. They're intimidated because, like, when I was there just hanging out, he was like, all of a sudden his mannerisms got a little different. He wanted to show his love a little more. He wanted to kiss his girlfriend a little more and all that. He got mad because I didn't want him to pour my drink. I said, no, I want the bartender to do it because she was the bartender.
Yeah. No, I didn't hear him say that at all.
Yeah, he said that, and then that's when he asked for the Zero song to play. The Zero song, he said that's when he said nigga.
Yeah, see, that's the part that fucked me up right there. Like, I'm gonna hit it right now. That's the part that fucked me up when he said that twice. I was like, yo, you can't say that. Well, I'm from the hood. I'm in Pflugerville.
I just looked at him like, hey, fam. Chill the fuck out.
Yeah. Man, we are from Austin. Pflugerville is not the hood.
Hello.
Let's see here. Hey, people, we're gonna do something different right here too. This pod.
Hello.
May I speak to Ashley?
This is her.
What up, ho?
Ashley, this is AC with Cut the Fuck Out Podcast with special guest Wells sitting in the building with me. How you doing, young lady?
I am great. Fantastic.
Are you outside?
I am not outside. It's too hot. It's 102 degrees. I'm definitely under this good ass AC.
We were just wondering. Should we ask her what we asked Hazel?
Yeah.
Do you want to ask her? Or you want me to ask her?
So Ash, when's the last time you just said, "Fuck it, I'm finna get on some nasty, nasty, nasty shit"?
Oh my God.
Nah, you wanted to come on, fam. We got you.
Like some nasty, nasty stuff. Like, yeah, what's nasty?
Hold on.
Slurp it up nasty like that.
Listen, so Hazel said that it got spicy. So I said, which one is you doing? Ghost chili, habanero, or jalapeno?
Oh, wow.
Now you got to pick a pepper, and then you got to tell me the story behind the pepper pick.
Oh, my God.
Like, when's the last time that you just said, you know what, I'm about to just do everything I want to, nasty-wise?
Okay, so I'm going to tell y'all. It was about 2 years ago on Father's Day. Yeah, 2 years ago on Father's Day. So I set up this room for my significant other, you know, decorated it, had on some lingerie, some tall heels. So when he walked in, you know, I was looking all good or whatever. And we got really nasty. It started in the jacuzzi with some whipped cream. And I always wanted to make like a banana split, like on the penis.
Oh, man.
And eat it.
So wait, what?
I ate dick that day. So I had whipped cream and strawberries. He made a little banana split out the dick and, you know, did all that. And then when we went, after we got out the hot tub or whatever, that's when it kind of got a little crazy. So I used the hog tie. The hog tie.
Just got real.
Yeah, we just went to town after that. It was
Mike like that. Wow.
It was real nasty. Like some nasty shit.
As we were asking Hazel, how excited are you to get down to Austin?
I'm really excited. Like, I'm really excited to turn up with Anthony because I know Anthony is going to be turned up, you know. And I'm really excited to see everybody. Like, we just going to have a good time. I'm going to make sure everybody has a good time.
How many people do you think are fucking in the house?
If Jay ends up coming, I know me and him will.
What'd you say?
We're gonna bump those boots. I said if Zay comes, you know, we bumping the boots for show. And then I think, honestly, I think y'all want to hear the tea. I think Wells and Nikki is gonna get it in.
I definitely see Wells and Nikki fucking. Wells and Nikki fucking.
Shout out to Nikki, yep. Man. Shout out to definitely Nikki, see Nikki. That.
So I'm looking forward to that because I'm going to be at the door listening with my ear.
Now you're just being nasty. Yeah. So I'm at the door listening.
Yeah, I'm going to put my ear to the door. I want to hear. Making sure my bro is doing what he's supposed to do. If we can't hear, then there's a problem.
I got you. I promise.
So, yeah. And Anthron, I don't know. You might be lucky with Kat. I think Anthron is aiming for Hazel. That's who I think he's aiming for.
Drop one of Clues bombs for Hazel.
Yeah.
No. All right. Yeah, look. Drop one of
Clues bombs for Hazel.
Yeah, I was about to drop. I was going to get air horn for that one. But no.
I think you're trying to do the Captain Morgan.
No. Do you know what? Wells, we talked about this pre-production before we even got on the pod. I say what I say to Kat for a reason.
Yeah, but is it reciprocated though?
What?
Whatever you say to her, is it reciprocated? Is she giving you that same energy back?
Oh, Yeah, she always does. She always does. I say what I say to Kat on live because I'm not gonna say it.
I feel you.
Yeah, and so when I say I'm bringing the girls back to the house, that's a reason why I said that. Can you guess why I would say that, Ash?
Just to test our waters.
Huh?
To test the waters.
If he brings girls back to the house, he fucking.
You were checking her temperature, wasn't you, to see what she was gonna say?
Oh, and she reacted the way I thought she was last night.
Hey, Ash, real quick.
I don't know, Anthron. Listen, let me just give you some advice. So I feel like you may have a chance. Just don't be so aggressive. Like, just be smooth about it. And you got to be real clear about it. And I think you may have a chance. But if you come off aggressive, you definitely—I don't think it's gonna happen.
I haven't come off aggressive with that girl at all. I've been sitting back and watching this.
No,
girl.
I mean, what you think may not be aggressive, I think kind of may come off. You know?
Okay, I got you.
But no, I'm telling you, I'm giving you free game. I'm telling you.
Okay, well, there you go. I appreciate you, Bishop Magic Don Juan.
Hey, Ash. Ash, real quick, tell. What? Ask them where they can follow you at. What you doing?
Wait, say that again.
Tell them where they can find you and what you're doing.
Oh, so yeah, you guys can follow me at ashb_cakes on Instagram and on TikTok. I do custom cakes. I do treats, infused treats. Anything you need, I got it.
Ash, I'm gonna link your bio and episode when I upload it because it will be out tomorrow. I'm not sending this to the editor. This is just gonna be fun today, so I'm gonna link you on the description of the pod. So,
okay, cool.
Just be prepared to get requests from around the world.
Oh,
that's the point.
Hey, okay, Ash. Well, I appreciate you. I love you guys.
Ash, real quick before you go, what you saying to the haters and hoes?
Oh, to the haters and hoes, suck it slow.
Shout out to Ash. I love you, sis.
Oh, man. All right, let's get some house cleaning things out the way real fast. Shout out to our first and last time listeners. Shout out to everybody who listens around the world. Let me see here. Shout out to Germany. Shout out to India. Shout out to Canada. Shout out to Israel. I didn't realize we were even in Israel.
Shout out to the Israelites.
Shout out to Trinidad and Tobago. Shout out to United Kingdom, Australia, Mexico. Hey, shout out to all y'all.
Shout out to the world.
Yeah, shout out to all y'all who actually listen to the pod. I couldn't do this without you guys. I love you guys. I respect you guys. Shout out to our sponsorships. Shout out to FNX Fitness for always taking care of my physical fitness needs. Shout out to Bright Smile for always taking care of my teeth. Love you guys for that. Now let's get back to it. Where are we at now? Do we want to talk about the 7-Eleven woman shooting the fuck out of the customer who beat her up?
What happened now?
So that was as a customer who walked into 7-Eleven, and apparently they got into a fight. She got into a fight with a 7-Eleven employee, and the employee took an ass whooping, but then the employee went to her bag. And let's just play the video. Let me just pull the video up real quick.
Oh, shit.
You haven't seen this?
Nah, man, I be trying to stay off YouTube and shit.
Nah, this was where the fuck was this at? I think I'd seen this on the Shade Room. Which, by the way, fuck the Shade Room. I gotta tell you guys, I hate the shit that they do. It's such fucking negative shit all the time.
But that's why it's called the Shade Room.
Yeah, but they don't report the good shit, though.
But that's why it's called the shade room. They're not gonna report the good shit unless it's like somebody making the law look bad or something like that.
Yeah, then that is clearly what they do.
But I mean, I don't got nothing bad to say about the shade room. Who knows? I might get a deal with them one day or something. Shout out to shade room.
Are you looking trying to get a deal? No, you trying to get in this media business?
I'm thinking about starting my own podcast, man, you know. I've been thinking about it for a while, though, for real. After I came over and seen how y'all did it. So I felt I could do it myself. Who knows, man? Who knows? AC, who knows?
Yeah. All right, hey. If you want to get one started, just let me know. I'll help you out as much as I possibly can. Let me see here. God damn it. I can't find the goddamn video now. I had it pulled up earlier.
I bet you did the lady go to jail that got shot?
I think she did.
She should have, because it was self-defense.
Yeah.
From me hearing that, what you said.
Well, I'm trying to find a damn video. And I think she did.
I am, man, hey. We on the second floor, really third floor, but I feel like I'm on the eighth floor.
You feel like you're on the eighth floor?
Yeah, I'm high. I'm high, bro.
It's high right now. Well, you just mix a lot of shit.
Yeah, shout out to the weed, man. Shout out to AC.
Shout out to
Cut It The Fuck Out podcast, man. And again, to the haters and hoes, suck it slow, suck it slow.
Hey, so, all right, man, what you want to get into next, man?
Do your thing, man. Do your thing.
All right, let's get into another thing right here. Where are we at with this one? So,
Anthony, let me ask you. Go ahead.
No, go ahead. Go ahead.
Let me ask you a question.
What's up? What's up?
Yeah, how can I put this?
Just say it, goddammit.
What kind of woman do you want? Let's find you a woman one day. I know, because you said you need to settle down. What kind of woman do you want?
Snickers said, let's find you a woman one day.
One day. Not today. I know it's not going to change overnight. Hell no. That takes like 10 years. So by the time you're 50, you're going to need what?
I would say that. So when it comes down to a woman that I want a woman who's confident. I want a woman who understands her value, but I don't want a woman who just thinks worldly of herself. Like, no man can treat me right. I can do this shit by myself.
Yeah.
Like, that's the shit I don't want.
Yeah.
Because I think that's the biggest turnoff, period. Because every man wants a woman that is going to be there for him, like, talk, but not talk down to him. And I think a woman that has that kind of worldly look for herself, that's who I do not want. At all.
Like, okay, so check this. Do you want a woman? So if you was finna get married, right? Like, you get married tomorrow, you know, you guarantee you're gonna live for the next 30 years, right?
Yeah.
You get married to this woman tomorrow. Do you want her to be a super freak right now? Or do you want to kind of teach her a little bit?
She could be
like mediocre, and you could turn her into what you want.
I think, I mean, at this day and age, and at my age, I think that's just gonna happen. Like, she's gonna be a super freak. I think she's gonna be a super freak, period.
From the jump,
I believe.
Wow.
I think she's gonna be a super freak from the jump. Because, I mean, at what, 38, 39, she's done some shit.
All right, what if you met a 40-year-old virgin?
Whoa. Whoa. So you mean Calvin?
No. In real life, you met a 40-year-old virgin. Beautiful. She's a virgin. Suck dick one time. I ain't gonna make a complete diversion.
Hey, I may have to keep her around for a while.
Would that be the one you marry? Y'all guaranteed to be living for the next 30 years. Guaranteed 30.
I think I would marry her. If she sucked dick once and she's a virgin, yo, I think I'm marrying her real quick. And here's the thing about old girl too. Old girl who came over this morning, yo, her body is right. She's not bad looking. She's cute. Like curly red hair, which I know redheads are straight freaks, and she just proved that shit again. But that may be something that you say to yourself, oh, she just moved here. She ain't fucked everybody yet. But I think that's going to change really soon. Yeah, I'm stupid.
This motherfucker here.
Yeah, I'm stupid.
Hey, his name is Mr. Nasty Town for a reason. Know that.
Oh, man.
Well earned and deserved.
Yo. That's just crazy. Hey, look at it. Here it is right here. She is whooping her ass.
God damn. Oh, then she kicked it?
Oh, she ain't done yet.
I bet you she wasn't finna pay for her shit.
Watch this.
You said she shot her in here? That's crazy, bro. Them niggas didn't even run. Damn, she shot her and she stomping her?
Yeah.
What kind of shit is that?
She shot her and she was stomping her. Yeah,
Hold on, fam.
Yo, you seen that shit.
That shit crazy, though. What the fuck?
Fam, I don't know what is going on in New York, but they are walling out there. That is some crazy shit right there.
That's something else.
She shot her, and then she started stomping her. That's...
At work, though.
At work.
And so, did she go to jail?
Oh, the employee?
The employee.
I don't think she went to jail. I think that may have been... That may have been self-defense. I don't know if she went to jail for that.
She went...
She went AWOL?
No, I'm saying because she stopped. And then she went to the thing and got the pistol. Now, she might have deserved to get an ass shot there because she beat the shit out there like for nothing. Then she kicked her. That's what probably got her over to like, bitch, I finna shoot you.
Yeah.
And then she started stomping her after she shot her. That's the part that's going to get her fucked up probably. That'll be the part that gets you fucked up when they show the part when she was stomping her afterwards with a big ass gunshot wound in the stomach.
Yeah, when she kept screaming, "You sorry now?
You sorry now?
Yeah, that's
you sorry. Goddamn.
They could probably try to hit her with premeditated.
Hey, I better stop playing with them behind the counter employees. They ain't fucking around.
At the end of the day, sometimes you never know what somebody's going through for a second.
You swung on me when I'm on the clock, fam. I can't even do nothing right now. You tripping.
She said, yeah, you swogging me. All right, well, guess what? You. Yeah, take this.
Bitch, money, but she probably, where was that at? New York?
That's in New York.
Like, they probably get held up so much.
That was at a Dollar General in New York.
That's crazy.
That, yeah, I don't know. I don't know. How do you feel about that one? That's like that. When you do some shit like that.
But I mean, it can be self-defense, though.
I think it is self-defense.
Because though. Technically, she hit the bitch first. The girl was on at work. And she stole off on her and beat the shit out of the girl and swing back one time. She was just blocking. But true. Then she shot her and then started stomping her.
Yeah, that's...
That's really kind of weak, though. Because she should have just... That's really kind of weak because she should have just started fighting her when the bitch stole off on her the first time.
Yeah, she should have got up because she just sat there and took that ass whooping.
Yeah, like... She said you let her do all this stomping and shit, and then you want to stomp her face. You could have did that when she hit you the first time. You should have whooped the bitch and then stomped her out and asked her what she saw. You fucking shot the bitch. You shit.
Wells, it's been a blast having you on the pod right now, man. You understand that we're at 52 minutes already? Didn't even feel really? Like 52 minutes.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn.
We're at 52. I was gonna do something that was out of line.
What?
And
cut it the fuck out.
Yep.
Do it.
Yep.
Do it.
All right. Hold on. Let me see where it's.
You gotta tell me what we're doing first. So I can know if I'm with it or not.
No.
Who are we calling?
I'm gonna make a phone call.
Who are we calling?
Hold on.
I don't want you to say nothing. Just as soon as they come in, let me talk for just like 1 minute. I want to see if I know how to do this or not.
All right. Well, let's see if she answers.
Yo, what's her name?
Your call has. Hey, what's?
All right, she didn't answer. This part is, well, I said I'm gonna limit to what we're gonna do an hour 15. We're at 53.
That's my pops. Just call him over.
Your call has been forwarded.
Bob said he ain't with the bullshit today. he said, oh, yeah, I'm not with the bullshit today. Bob's not answering that.
Yeah, he left that alone.
Yeah, he said, I'm out of here with that one. let me see. We come to the part of the show where we have to pick someone to just say, cut it the fuck out. Since you're a guest on the show today, I'm going to let you go first. Who do you think that just needs to cut it the fuck out? Man. Just anyone. It can be a politician. It can be a talk show host.
I think I need to tell all the motherfuckers out here that's like all the negative energy motherfuckers, the people that's down in everybody, that's trying to break everybody down, not trying to build each other up, that's not trying to help us. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Fuck them. They need to cut it the fuck out. Get on the right game. Get on the program. Let's get together. You know what I'm talking about? Let's do some shit all together to where we can take back over. We don't have to work for them. We don't have to worry about them because we have us. See what I'm saying?
Hey. That's some shit right there that people don't understand sometimes. Like, it's not about being better than the next person. It's about being a better person for you. Like, I'm not downing anyone. Every time, let's make money together. Let's build each other up. Let's not just stop the bullshit. Like you said, let's just stop the bullshit and help each other out.
And also, man, y'all start getting these kids, man. Start taking care of y'all kids. Y'all do what we got to do for these kids. Like, for real. Like, that shit's serious. Because when we're gone, it's like that shit can happen any day. Y'all gotta get it together. All of us, not just, I'm not saying y'all, I'm saying all of us, me included. All of us together as black people. We got to get it together, bro. And we got to start raising these kids to understand TV and the internet. That rap shit is fake. Like, they have to start understanding that shit's not real life. Like, niggas, kids is out here dying. I haven't seen my daughter go to 5 different funerals in the last 4 months.
And that's scary.
And these are 16-year-old kids, 15-year-old kids, 16, 15. 18-year-old kids getting killed in the street, shooting each other. Come on, bro. That shit's got to stop. Like, that shit has got to stop.
Yeah, when I seen that story that came out of Chicago where a 16-year-old was shooting at cops, I said, man, this world is different right now. Like, these kids are fucking crazy.
And it's the music. A lot of, I'm not going to say it's all the music, but a lot of it is the music, bro. Like, they have to start pushing something other than just trap shit. Selling dope, selling pills, taking pills, because it's not even about being the seller, making the money no more. It's about being the dude that's on perks and all that shit. That shit's crazy. That shit's corny, bro.
And I say this shit again. You can't fucking take every drug you hear about out here. Like, stop fucking doing that. If you not paying attention to how people are overdosing on, they think it's coke, but it's fentanyl. I'm just saying this before when we started the pod.
Yeah.
When he overdosed on what he thought was coke, but it was actually laced with fentanyl. Like, come on, man. People are selling y'all weed that's not even weed. Shit, synthetic shit, and having motherfuckers pass out and die.
You motherfuckers, y'all just got to get it together, bro. That shit's not, like, I'm not telling nobody I'm better than nobody or I'm the perfect mother. Hell no, but shit, we all got to do, but that shit's crazy, bro. Like, seeing all these kids die, all these young people dying, bro, about, like, behind bullshit. That's like, motherfuckers don't know how to fight no more. Just like, no. Fight, get it over with. You see them again, if you want to fight them again, there it is.
Nigga, we used to do that shit all the time. Like, all right? You see, you know, you whoop me this day, guess what? You got to see me again.
Unless you don't want to fight no more and it's just cool after that, that shit's like, come on, bro. You rather do that than have, you don't got, now your kids don't have nobody. Your kids don't have no daddy no more.
And that's,
your kids don't have no mama no more. The women is doing the same shit too, though. Like, it's women out here that are just as hood as a lot of these dudes, bro.
Women these days are hood. Women these days
I'm not bashing her down at any woman or anything like that. I love all women. Honestly, I love all women. I don't give a damn. Black, white, green, orange, purple, blue, whatever. But if you seen a blue bitch, that'll be crazy, right?
Oh, man. Show me a blue bitch. I'm
if you seen a blue bitch, that'll be crazy. Right?
What the fuck?
I swear, you showed me a Terminator bitch.
You showed me a blue bitch. What would the pussy be like?
Oh, my God.
Would it be, because you know they said a black and a blue, Barely Swedish. Juice. That bitch is blue black.
Ooh.
So what did that mean?
That pussy might be.
Would you try to get her pregnant and see what she come out with?
Yo, what the fuck did he just say?
What the fuck?
I think you gotta get a blue bitch pregnant.
If you found the first blue bitch in the world, okay, check this out. You go on a safari to Africa, right? You done heard of this blue bitch. They got a mythical thing. It's this blue bitch that's out there, man. That bitch bad. We done seen her, but can't nobody ever find her. Don't know where she at. You seen this blue bitch. That blue bitch come to you. And she understand English and all that. She wanna fuck. First blue bitch ever on earth.
I think you got no choice. It's your duty to mankind to get this blue bitch pregnant. You gotta get the blue bitch pregnant. As a black man, I'm trying to get the blue bitch pregnant. I want to see if the baby gonna come out green. Can you
purple? That bitch might come out purple.
It's gonna come out.
Look like a little eggplant. Pause.
Oh man, yeah, that's like, I definitely got it.
Hey, check this out. What if you ran across a bitch with two pussies?
Bro, I'm glad this girl is married now, and I know that she doesn't like me, and I'm cool with that now. But I can honestly tell you, and I'm just cut the fuck out podcast. There's no reason for me to lie about anything. I've done that before.
No, you're not listening. Listen, one woman has two pussies,
and I'm telling you.
Hold on, wait, what? Wait, drop. Hey, drop a clue. What the fuck? Wait, what the fuck? Not that one. Another one. What the fuck?
What the fuck?
No, I'm.
Bro, what is this bitch's name? Because she has to be famous. She has.
No, she is. Oh, let me. I can actually.
She has two pussies.
Yes, I can actually show you the article. Her name is Teresa.
You fucked her?
Her name, yes.
Both of them.
No, it was weird as shit when I first.
Both of them? Encountered. You fucked both of them?
No, I didn't.
Did it look like two full pussies or was it a little limp pussy on the side?
No, it's they're really on top of each other.
So it was like this. So her lips were like this.
Yeah, it was one right here, and then there's one below.
Oh, it was like an ant pile.
Yeah, it's yo, this nigga right here.
That bitch had a balcony pussy. Oh shit, bro! Hold on, wait a minute.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull it up.
You fucked her?
Yeah.
In both holes?
No, I just told you no.
Bro, you have to come on my live later on. Hey, y'all make sure y'all follow me, man. Mr. Wells. Is it Mr. Wells? No, you know what? It's not Mr. Wells. It's Radio Wells. Radio Wells. Radio _ Wells. RADIO _ Wells. Find me on IG. Check my pajama jams off the chain. I promise you, my pajama jams, they finna start getting some recognition here in a little bit. Trust me.
Yes. So she lives in Wichita. She lives in Wichita, Texas.
Anthony, you're coming on my live tonight and telling me this story, bro.
Family, I have no reason to lie to my audience.
No. I'm saying I want you to come tell this story on my live, though. I want you to come tell this. I'm going to hear it now because there's no way I'm not going to let you tell that story now because I want.
Yeah, no, she literally told me, like, she was like, She sent me an article. She sent me an article, and she said, "I just want to tell you this before I actually meet you, because she was coming down here, and she sent me the article, and she literally has two vaginas. Like, she has two vaginas, but she's married now. Shout out to her if she ever listens to this pod. I hope she doesn't.
Shout out to the double pussy.
Yeah. Yo, what the fuck is wrong with this dude right
here? Let me ask you a question, bro. So check this out. So how did it, like, how, so I say, I know what a regular pussy is, right? So then where was the other one at? Like, up on the pelvic? Like, on the pelvic area? Or?
No, it's literally right underneath the other one.
Underneath? Hold on. Wait. So, see, that's what I'm saying. Like, I'm trying to vision it. Like, I'm trying to vision in my eyes how that shit looks. And I can't see it.
Well.
But I just can't see it. Like, two pieces, bro.
It's one here. And then it's one there. They're literally on top of each other. It's behind the other one. Yo, this nigga right here is going nuts on this pod right now. I knew this pod was going to be crazy. Yeah. I didn't know we were going to get this goddamn crazy.
This bitch booty hole was on her back.
Yo.
This booty hole up, way up here, after all the way up here on this side, at the top
Yo,
of
her crazy. This nigga crazy. Right.
That's, I ain't never seen no shit, heard no shit like that. Now I got to see that.
Yeah, hold on. Me too. I can pull.
You have to show me that one, brother.
Yeah. Literally. It's literally like that. Literally, just like that.
And you fucked both of them?
No, I just... Stop saying that! I just said I didn't fuck both of them.
I mean, did you try? I know you tried to.
I know I tried. Yeah, I did. Yo, I was...
Warning, nigga detected.
Warning, nigga I know you detected. Tried to.
Yeah, I definitely tried to. Yeah, it's definitely a different experience right there.
Was you fingering the other one or
no?
Like, bro, you have to tell. Like, you can't just.
All right, Wells. I was fingering.
Cut it the fuck out.
I did put my hand in the other one. I was fingering the other one too. I did try to fuck both of them. I did try to.
What did she say? Was she a virgin? She was like, what if she was like, hey, I'm saving that one for my husband.
Nah.
What the fuck?
No, that was
saving that one for my husband. That's crazy.
That was a crazy thing about it. Like, I could finger the other one, but she wouldn't let me fuck the other one. Like, I was that shit right there intrigued me when she sent me the article. And I literally knew that she really does have two fucking vaginas.
Was it wet?
Oh yeah. Yeah. I started asking dumb questions. I was like, do you have two periods?
See, that's the shit. I need to find a pussy doctor that can tell me some shit like this about the double vaginosis. That's what I'm gonna call it.
You gonna call it what?
Double vaginosis. Double that.
Yo, this nigga right here.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what? I was trying to get out of here, but we're gonna make one more phone call and then we're gonna get out of here. It's my uncle. We're gonna ask him this question real quick.
Yeah, hello.
Yo, can I speak to Uncle Bug?
What's the problem?
Uncle Bug, it's your nephew, AC with Cut the Fuck Out Podcast. We got a special guest in the building sitting in with me today. Wells is in the building with me. Say what's up, Wells.
The Domino King. You remember me. You remember me, Uncle Bug.
What the hell?
Uncle Buck, so we're on a pod right now, and this question just came up. We've made this whole shit. Would you fuck a girl who has two vaginas?
Who has who?
She has two vaginas.
Would I hit it?
Yeah.
God damn, boy. That's a damn good question, boy. You think something wrong with her ass, man?
All right, Uncle Bob, what did she do? What is she?
He got a special gift.
Uncle Bud, but what if she told you when you tried to fuck? What if when she told you when you tried to fuck the other one, she said, "I'm saving that one for marriage."
I probably, man, that's kind of hard to say. Because nigga be shocked at that shit. Boy, nigga didn't expect it. Nothing like that.
Yeah. I'm crying. how you think I felt when that happened?
I would have been fucked up. I ain't trying to disrespect you, but am I seeing clear? I want to know if my vision ain't fucking with me or if you ain't fucking with me. Man, I'm beginning to see two things. I know I ain't that fucked up.
Now you seeing clear.
Now you seeing clear.
You seeing clear for sure.
I got to ask her, well, what the fuck happened to her? Where the fuck she come from? How the hell did that shit happen?
Would you try to fuck her? So check this out. So if you fuck both of them, is it considered a threesome?
Wait, what?
I'm just saying that's two different pussies in one dick.
Yeah. He got me for a man. Hey, like she be got mad at me. She be ready to go home. I'd be pissed off, man. I don't think I'd be able to get no ass. Then I fucked it up.
Hey, man, you got it, man. I'm just happy that she gave me the heads up before she came. I was just happy she gave me the heads up before she came.
Oh, right there. Before she got there, she told me about it.
Yep. She sent me an article. I'm trying to find the article right now. Cause this right here, I'm literally trying to show this nigga right here. And God damn it. We gotta edit this name out. But yeah, she literally told me about it before she came.
Is this her?
No, that's not her. I'm trying to find the article she sent. I'm gonna have to go to my fucking Twitter to find it, I think.
You are tuned in to Credit the Fuck Out podcast with your host AC. It's your boy DJ. Dick him down on the phone. We got Uncle Bub.
Yeah, I can't find a.
And to the haters and hoes, suck it slow, suck it slow.
All right, man. I just had to call you on the pod right now, man. I had to.
That would have fucked me up for real. Hey, like, I don't be expecting nothing like that. If I ever run into a female like that, man, I'm pretty sure you're going to hear about it. And she's going to post my ass on Facebook, talking about I'm very disrespectful, I don't know how to sit up and talk to people. She's going to really go off on me. I don't know what that takes. Gee, you are not normal.
One last question, Uncle Bud, because I just thought about it. If you was 38 and you met a 40-year-old virgin, would you marry her?
Who?
A 40-year-old virgin.
A 40-year-old virgin.
Yeah, would you marry her? Like, and you like 38. You know you're going to live for at least 30 more years, 40 more years. Guaranteed.
What I'm marrying. I can't really say because I'm wondering why in the hell she waited so goddamn late.
But look,
the hell ain't nobody else put a ring on it.
But it's a gesture.
Man, I got some questions.
Look. Is she beautiful?
I just can't jump in, man.
Check this out.
Been holding out all goddamn long.
Hold on. Let me give you the rest of it though, so you can know what I'm talking about. So she 40-year-old virgin, beautiful, like beautiful, beautiful, long, pretty, her body and everything, right? Millionaire, looking for a man to have a baby, right? Only catch to it, she's blue.
Yo. Uncle Bug, you fucking her. Don't lie. You fucking her.
A 40-year-old virgin?
But she blue.
If she blue.
Yep.
Like her skin. Her skin is
that's
blue.
That's definitely an alien. I ain't got time for my shit disappear.
No, Unc.
Alien, fuck you up.
Nah,
you don't know what the hell's all in them damn jeans.
Unc, check this out. She's a regular woman.
Nigga put in, can't even fill himself full ass because motherfucker down.
Nah, look. check this out. She's a regular woman. She just had a skin condition that turned to blue. She's the only person in the world like this. No diseases. She's a real woman, but she's blue. Are you fucking?
Oh, shit. Hell no.
Are you coming for the beautiful blue bitch?
Shit. Man, she blue and she got bad skin disease and she rare. Damn.
But she's a millionaire. She's super rich. Take care of you for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
All she want is a baby.
I'm putting it like this. Shit. Nigga ain't trying to be a nigga. Hey, I be in line. I'm not trying to be your nigga.
You
one of a kind. Man, you is blue. Literally. Shit, you is not right. What the fuck happened to your mom and your dad when they made you?
They
I gotta sit up there and see them motherfuckers. I wanna know if they aliens. What are y'all? Where y'all come from? Y'all part of an experiment?
All right, Unc, man. I'm gonna get you the hell off this line now. This nigga right here.
Shout out Uncle Bug. All right, Unc. Hey, Unc. I'll be over there to dominate the domino table again in a couple of days. Okay.
Don't Uncle Bug. You were there. You witnessed
Uncle Bug.
It.
You remember me from the other night.
You witnessed this.
The guy that sat down and didn't move.
Oh God.
You remember me, Uncle Bug?
All right, man. I'm getting you off the phone, man. I love you, Unc.
Shout out to Uncle Bug, man.
Love you too, baby.
All right.
Have a good one, man.
All right. That's Uncle Bug right there. That was a hell of a good question right there. That was fun.
What?
Yeah, that nigga said, yo, she's a different kind of person. Yo, clearly she is.
Something wrong with you.
Yeah, where's your family at?
They said you ain't right.
I do have to do one thing before I get out of here. I did tell this lady that I would call her, so. I'm gonna call her.
You never did tell them who to cut it the fuck.
I know. I'm not there yet. I'm about to get to there. I'm gonna make this last one. This should be hilarious. I'm gonna see.
Who is this?
Bill.
Oh shit! Hold on. Don't say. Let me get her for real.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 3-1.
Hello.
We have to get Bell.
Yeah, let me check.
Hello, Belle. You are on the line with DJ Dick'em Down. How are you today, sweetheart?
I'm doing good.
I'm doing good, DJ Dick'em Down. That's how Belle gonna be.
Yeah, she. Yeah, I did tell her. I did tell her I would call her when I was recording the pod. So I'm gonna be a man of my word, like I said, and I am going to call her. And we are almost on the time limit right now. Not really a time limit, but you gotta try to keep it to 1:30, somewhere around there. An hour and 30 minutes. Give you guys an hour and 30 minute pod. Uh-oh.
Come on, my bell.
I know. Hey, no, I thought it was you. I was just, you know how you don't feel like reading through something and then you copy it and you press select all and you have them read the letter back to you? That's what I was doing when you had called.
Excuse me.
How you doing?
Excuse me. You on the line with
hello?
DJ. Hey, my bell. You on the line with
hello?
DJ. Hello, my bell. Can you hear me?
Who is that?
This is DJ Dick'em Down. How are you, sweetheart?
All right.
Wait a minute.
Oh. All right, here we go.
Yeah,
I
this
thought it
is
was
DJ Dick'em Down. Talking to my girl, my bell. What's up, sweetheart?
You're live on Cut the Fuck Out.
Look,
yeah, you're live on Cut the Fuck Out podcast. Wells is in the building with me today.
Where is Swaz?
Swaz, that's who.
Where's my nigga Swaz?
I don't know. We're on a pod. We're recording a pod right now.
And you don't know if Swaz is there.
No, Bill, you're actually on the podcast right now. This is not IG Live.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, this is not IG Live. Get your shit together right now. This is not IG Live.
Wait. You don't just call somebody, okay?
I did.
And just tell them. No, you tell them ahead of time.
I did.
The day before. No, you didn't. That was last week.
I just texted you and said we're calling you live on the pod.
Thank you. I'm lying.
I just texted you and told you we're live on the pod.
No, I'll tell you your text said.
Oh, my
anyway,
God.
Hello, everyone. How are you?
Hey, I'm doing good. We were just going through some questions for a little bit, having some fun. One of the questions that we had, we had Hazel on earlier. We had Ash on earlier. My uncle came on for a little bit. So the question that we had was, when's the last time that you just said, fuck it, I'm about to go crazy when I sleep with this person? When's the last time you said that?
That I would go crazy if I had the opportunity to sleep with someone?
Yeah. Like you just said, I'm about to do some freaky shit.
Well, it wasn't with you. I didn't have those dreams. But it could be a person who's sitting next to you. I'm just kidding. I'm just saying. Mr. Wells. I'm just kidding.
Shout out my bell.
Hey, shout out to Bill for shooting her bell. I wish I had another one, but I'm just going to play this one for you.
Horny nigga detected.
No, okay, Bill. Okay.
How many minutes you got left?
We got...
Oh, my goodness.
Actually, I'm just trying to keep it at 1:30, 1:35. So we got 15.
So we can call Swaz in 10 minutes.
Yeah, we can call him in 10 minutes. Yeah, okay, I'm going to try to keep it 1:30.
Threats.
Yes.
You're going to edit this, right?
There's no edit for this one. No, this one's just going to go on live today.
Yeah, we're just doing the damn thing today.
Yeah. I'm not sending this to the editing team at all today. I just said we're going to record. And then
you're just gonna feed it raw. It's just gonna be raw tape.
This is gonna be raw tape.
So everything we're saying right now is going to be on the air, or
Yeah, yeah. So okay. I will. Once we're done, I'm just gonna upload it to the server. And
but we'll what go. I'm saying is, what we're talking about right now, shop talk behind the scenes, is this going to be aired raw
yes.
this?
Yes.
Oh my god.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It is. You are live on the air with DJ Dick'em Down. My Belle, let me ask That's you. My DJ Belle, let me ask yeah. you a question. Let me ask you a question, my Belle. Tell me what turns a woman on like you, 54 years old, beautiful. Successful.
Yo, if you don't get your Barry White voice the fuck out of here right now and just ask the fucking question.
I've got to throw out the...
He's eating the mic.
Pause. Pause. I'm not. It's no eat mic. It's no mic eating.
Cut it the fuck out. You
are eating. Hey, but my bad. I'm just saying. Let somebody know. It might be a 58, 54, maybe a 40 year old man that's out there. Like, hey, I need her. I'm coming to get her.
How old are you, DJ Dick'em Down? 37.
Yes,
that's
ma'am.
Perfect.
Whoa. What did you just say?
He's 37. I said that's perfect.
Okay, so tell me what you want, my bear.
You let me know when. What did you say?
I said you tell me what do you want? What do you want?
Yo, this
Well, what do I want?
Yes, ma'am.
What do I want you to do, Wells?
What you want me to do?
Something that looks like your mouth can do well, among other things.
Oh, yeah.
Next question.
Like what else?
Can you handle that?
Can I handle? Yeah, I definitely can handle you. Tell me some more. Let me know. We talking grown folks talking now. Let's talk. Don't blush. I said black people don't blush, but I just lied because she definitely did. I know she did.
Again. Hold on. Let me just preference this by saying this. Belle, are you coming in September?
Yes, I will be coming in September.
Okay. I see what you just did there, and I'm sure you will be coming in September. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you will.
Yeah, hey,
that was a double on. That was a double on time.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I got it.
I know it's at bars.
And to those in the podcast world, DJ Dick'em Down.
She spit bars right there. She was spitting.
Hey, Bill.
You two motherfuckers are insane.
Hey, Bill.
And I love you both. You're like my brothers. You know, Bill, I'm not going to really speak with Wells.
So, Bill, tell me this. If me and you are in a room alone together, late night.
What you say, darling? Reincarnate.
Listen, if me and you are in a room together, me and you together, nobody else, dark, what are we doing?
Okay.
What are we doing?
Are we going to find, where would we go?
No. He said, what are we doing?
Me and you are in a bedroom together.
Oh, the two of us, if we were to get together by ourselves?
Yeah.
Sexually?
Sexually.
Intimately?
Intimately.
Erotically. And sensually.
Yo, well, you can repeat that how many times you want to. It's still going to be the same shit.
Look.
With DJ Dick'em Downs? Come on. What do you think, Mr. Nasty Time? Thrax. And I call Anthrax Thrax because when I had first seen his name to the people in the audience, okay, who were listening, I thought it said Anthrax because I'd never seen a person's name, you know, Anthron. So when I initially looked at it without my glasses, I said, Anthrax, that's an interesting name. So that's why I called
him. Hey, Bill. You're running away from me right now. I need you to
Thrax, how do you feel about that?
Yo, she is avoiding that question like a motherfucker. She's avoiding that question like the plague right now.
Hey, Bell, you running away from me right now. I don't need that. Come here.
It's not, but it's not that I'm really, avoiding it. His voice is so rich, and he's just really eating that mic so centrally. I can't really hear it. I can't really hear everything he's saying. I can only pick out.
So I need to.
And we're coming through two mics here.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Oh, so what are we doing, Belle?
Okay. What would we be doing? Well, we'd take one of the rooms at the mansion where you guys are now, at the Kavanaugh Mansion, Anthrax's home. Maybe he'll let us have the basement. And we would just really go at it. What do you think? Would you be up to that?
What you want to do, Belle?
What I want you to do?
Yeah.
To start at?
What you want me to do? Kiss you where?
Oh, Lord, don't be talking to me like that. Let's see. Start with the neck.
Kiss you. Okay.
You know?
Kiss you on your...
And, you know, kiss in the neck, you know, gently. Well, the mouth first. What that mouth do? Kissing your lips first, okay. And you know, then you just go on down.
Okay.
You know, and then we'll both go on down.
Oh.
Like the showcase. You know, like The Price is Right.
Hold on, I got you right now. I got you, Bill.
Come on down. What?
Hey, Bill.
Yo,
you hear me?
Bear, you right, hear me? So you're getting a rise out of
Bear,
it.
Bear, do you hear me?
No, what I'm about to say, there's gonna be a lot of fucking going on this.
hey, let me let
That's
y'all know.
For real.
Let me let y'all know, man. I respect my Belle. She know I love her. I would never disrespect her like that ever. But she know that's my cougar though. Shout out to my Belle.
Oh man, this shit's gonna be that real world house. It's gonna be a long 5 days. God.
What'd you say? A real raw house?
Yeah, this is gonna be a real world house right here. It's gonna be a long 5 days.
Yes.
Hey, Miss Belle.
I thought he said raw house.
I love you, Miss Belle.
I love you too, darling. And it's just Michelle, you know. It's Michelle, my Belle.
No, it's my you, Miss Belle. Hey, Miss Belle, but listen.
Oh, whoa! Repeat that.
Hold on. Before I let you go, my Belle. Before I let you go, let me ask you a question. What are we saying to the haters and to the hoes?
What are we saying to the haters and to the hoes, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, to all those, you know, whole hoes out here, not half a hoes, you know, continue to be a hoe. Stay in your lane. Stay in your lane. Don't come around me. I don't want no hoes. Because see, Wells, you ain't a hoe. Now, to the haters, let them hate. Because they ain't going to get nowhere with nothing. Mm-mm. I ain't gonna get nowhere. And to Thrax.
Oh my Thrax. God. What in the hell do you gotta say now?
You're my brother, but I would have sex with Mr. Wells, not with you, because you're more brotherly, you know. Yeah. You're brotherly kind of friend.
Oh, so you rather fuck Wells and fuck me?
Oh man.
Well. Get the fuck out of here. Yes. Podcast. Get the fuck out of here. You all are going to get me in trouble again. You young motherfuckers.
Oh, man.
I can't help it. It's just y'all just do this. Then Thrax, you are off the chain. You explode in your chair. You laugh so heartily. And it is just so hilarious. And you don't even realize it. It's like you're sitting on an IED.
Yeah.
An improvised device. And you fall out of your chair when you laugh. And I love it. Mm-hmm.
Hey, I will say this, Bill. You are right. I would definitely not try to fuck you, Belle. I definitely would not try
again.
Stop it. Don't stop it.
A horny nigga detective.
Wells, you know what he did. Wells,
I'm not in that, Miss Belle.
I'm
not involved in that.
Yeah, stop it. You keep hearing the narrative of the goddamn Uber driver. That wasn't Uber driver. That was my little cousin.
Oh, so that makes it better. You wanted to run a train.
Nah, we're good.
So that's, is that a train?
Hey, my bell.
Bell.
Mel, we're going to let you go because we got Swaz on the line.
All right. Tell Swaz to please give me a call.
All right. We love you, Bell. You have a great day.
I love y'all.
All right.
Bye. Have a good one. Bye.
Antoine. Yeah.
Well, brother.
Hey, hold on real quick. Coming to the mic, we got my boy Swazi, a.k.a. My God. Shout out to Swaz and Swaz TV, the Swaz Angels and everything. Man got going. My brother, how's it going? How you doing, sir?
I'm doing good. Well, I appreciate the beautiful introduction. Thanks for having me. What's going on, Anton? What's going on?
Swaz, you were live on Cut the Fuck Out podcast.
The uncut version.
The uncut version. This is going to be released tomorrow.
Guess what, Swaz?
You're the closer.
Do I need to cut something the fuck out? Do I need to remove something from my life, Anthony? Do I need to know something?
Hey, it's about whatever you want.
This is what we do. This is what this...
I would not cut the fuck out would be sleeping with Belle, to be honest.
Huh?
Yes.
Facts.
I said one thing I would not cut the fuck out is sleeping with Belle. That is one of the hottest mature women I know.
Facts.
Thank you.
So you definitely fucking that.
I'm not saying definitely. She's such a mature woman. I wouldn't say it that way. I would say she's worth the pursuit. Yes.
Okay.
Facts.
Definitely worth the pursuit.
You're not coming on here, right? Oh man. Yeah. It's a whole thing. It's a whole trip going on soon. Yeah.
Hey, we're gonna meet my bell, Swaz.
What do you mean? We're gonna meet it.
So a couple of us, me, Anthron, Ash, Nikki, E. White, a couple other people, they all gonna come down here to Austin in September.
Oh, that's dope. Yeah. That's fire.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sound like the cool lunch table to me.
Man, but it's gonna be.
I never got a chance to do that thing, Anthony.
It's gonna be like.
How you get there?
Huh?
How do I get there? I gotta win tickets.
Nah, you want to come?
Hey, you want to come?
If you really want to come, bro, I definitely get you.
What type of? What are you talking about, Wells?
I'm just saying.
What do you mean? I'm full. Come on, Bell. I would definitely love to come, man.
I got you. I'll holler at you.
Bell, Wells, Anthony. Oh, come on now. That sounds like the camera needed.
Look, Ash.
Sounds like we need a cameraman to me.
Ash, I'm just saying.
We got Ash, we got Hazel, we got Kat,
Wait, Freak, you said who?
We got Ash, we Ash, got Hazel, Hazel, we got E. White.
Halo?
We got Kat.
No, 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 not Halo. Hazel.
Oh.
That nigga was about to go crazy. He was about to go crazy on his pod.
Shout out to Halo. Hoochie Daddy.
Shout out to Halo. That's the fan for real.
Yo, can we get Halo down here?
I probably could. I would expect. Nah, I got a really good relationship with Halo.
Huh?
Hey, see if you can add her to the call.
Oh yeah, I don't know. I can't promise you that. I ain't that
sly. No, I'm just saying. I'm saying you can do it.
Right y'all giving me more props than I deserve. Hold on, let's see.
I know you do.
Is this?
That's why I expect you to be able to do it.
Yo, what is this on? Is this IG or Lobby?
That's IG.
IG.
Hold on, let's see. Because if I add it to the call, then you don't got to do anything special. Oh, look at that. I guess I am a little more connected than I thought. Welcome to the call, Halo. Halo, before you speak, this is a recorded line. We are now on Antron's podcast.
You're now called.
Halo, what's up, baby?
Hello. You're now live on Cut the Fuck Out podcast. Just so you know.
Halo. They asked if I could get you to speak for a couple moments. I thought I heard your name, so I mentioned you and obviously shouted you out. And I said, I do know, I don't know if she'll join, but we'll see.
Okay, I'm here. Busy? What'd you say?
I said, you busy?
No, I'm good. What's going on?
Gentlemen right here, I accidentally mentioned your name because I thought I overheard your name. And after I heard your name mentioned, I shouted you out. And they said, I do know Halo. We have a pretty good working relationship. They're like, can you get in here? I said, I don't know. And I tried my luck and you're here, Halo.
Hey, but Halo is the fam, though. Halo, what's up, man?
What's up? What you got going on? You said it's a recorded line. We on air. What's going on?
Yeah. So you're live on Cut the Fuck Out podcast right now. And we were telling Swazi that we had a whole trip that's coming up. Everybody's coming down here. So we say, can we get you down here?
He said Halo. And he said, wait a minute, Halo?
And then when they were giving listing the names of the people going down, I thought I heard your name. I was like, Halo going? I was like, because, yeah, I'm definitely pulling up. And they said, no, not Halo. I was like, oh.
Where y'all going? Oh, so I ain't invited?
You definitely.
Well, that's what I thought. I said, well, if Halo was there, I got it. I'm definitely going at that point. So now that you're here, would you consider going if you knew I was going to be there and a couple people that you know?
Going where?
To Austin.
Boston?
Austin. In September.
To Texas.
Oh, Texas, Austin, Texas. Yeah, I'll consider going, yeah.
Do you, okay, hold on. Let me just say this right now. We, I think we looked at a 6-bedroom mansion or something like that last night that we're talking about the Airbnb.
We'll talk about that offline or whatever.
Yeah, we'll figure that out.
So if you down, September 15th through I think the 19th that we were talking about right now.
Okay.
September 15th through the 19th, Halo. Can you do?
Yeah, that's cool. My birthday is on the 7th, so my schedule will be open after that. So that's cool.
Oh, wow. Birthday
on the 7th.
Say no more. Let's add her to the group later on.
So what's going on? But like, I need to know, like, what's going on.
I just said there needs to be a camera. That's first of all. Like at this point, you got Wells, Halo, Anthron, Ash. There's big names. Bell, all these different faces. Like, I don't know. I'm sure we can figure out some things to do.
We already got those plans. We already got those planned. We got brunch and shit set up. We got chefs.
Will there be cameras, Anthron? That's what Halo wants to know.
We need cameras. I need set up for a comedy night. Like, I want to go get on the stage in Austin. I want to go to comedy. Yeah,
this is what happens when you start going after the divas, gentlemen. They're going to have requests.
Y'all need to get with y'all promoters and see how do y'all get, like, what comedy nights is specials. Like, I'm trying to show y'all who Halo is in your city. You feel me? And let your city know that you got someone that's very talented that could come and rock the stage,
That's a fact.
Hey, Halo, this coming out tomorrow, so tell them who you are and what you got going.
You say what?
I said this is coming out tomorrow. He gonna drop this tomorrow, right? So for the people who don't know who you are, tell them what you got going and who you actually are.
Oh no, like I'm an artist. I'm a rapper. I go by the name of Halo the Dominatrix for as far as music. I'm a comedian, Halo Funny as Fuck with a PH. You can follow me on Instagram, TikTok, and like I'm just a content creator. Like I'm just all around creative. Like, so, period. You feel me? Like, period.
I will tell you this. If you want to do a stand-up night, that Saturday night, I know a girl who hosts an open mic, and I can get you signed up for it. Shout if you want to do it.
Shout out to
that's
Ellen.
What we. Yes, that's what I want to do. And then everybody that's going to be with, you know, at the house, y'all go come out. We're going to have a good time, do the comedy, rock the stage. That's what's going on.
Yeah, we can. I can definitely set that up for you. We can. That's going to be crazy. All of us.
I might have an listen. Halo. I don't know if you want to share the bill. We'll talk behind the scenes.
Okay.
Yeah. So, Wells, you wanna ask the question we've been asking people on the pod lately?
Swaz, check this out. Check this out.
I'm listening, and I'm listening closely.
So you meet.
Talking to Mike.
So you meet a 40-year-old virgin, right?
Wait, a 40-year-old woman virgin?
Yeah, beautiful. 40-year-old virgin, beautiful.
Okay, all right. Beautiful 40-year-old virgin. I'm here.
Guarantee you're gonna live 40 years. Guaranteed, right? From where you are now, guarantee you got 40 more years, easy. Okay? She's multimillionaire and everything like that. Are you going to marry her?
Am I going to marry her just because she's a virgin?
I'm just saying, with all those, listen, so with all those qualifications, the only thing she wants is a baby, but she wants to marry. She wants to marry the guy. Are you going to marry her?
She wants to marry the what?
Hold on, before
I got you.
Yeah, I'm about to say, tell him to catch.
Hold on. You know I'm listening for the catch. I'm from New York. I know we got to catch a cab somewhere.
Like this. What's going on? Look, check this out. This is literally the perfect woman. I know this is hypothetical because I know she doesn't. Nobody exists. Nobody's perfect. But this is, in your eyes, the perfect woman. Beautiful, everything, rich, got successful, same kind of mindset you want, all that, right? Virgin, 40 years old. Only thing she wants to do is get married and have one baby.
Okay.
Would you do it?
That's the only thing I got to be concerned with is that she wants one child in marriage.
Yo, this nigga. So,
is she the 40-year-old virgin?
So look, the catch is...
Can you fill me in, Wells? What the hell?
So the catch is...
Because this don't sound right. This sounds like perfection.
The catch is, she's blue. Look. So could you overlook that and be like, man, but you actually fuck with her, like, man, hey, this bitch is blue, but I really fuck with her a little bit. Like, would you do it? Cause she still can have kids at this time. Would you do it?
Halo, would you do it, Halo?
Would you
fuck a blue man?
A blue man, a man that I don't know. What you mean, blue?
40-year-old virgin. So a woman ain't gonna want a 40-year-old virgin. So you already lost it with that one.
So no, I'm just saying that's why I said hypothetically.
So for me, hypothetically, when I deal with a blue woman, just because she's a virgin, she wants to get married, have one child. No thing. I'm good. I may not be the flyest dude, but I got more options than that.
No. But check this out.
Oh, wait, hold on. What'd you say, Halo?
Halo, you there?
I think she just disappeared out there. Yeah, I don't know if she's still there. I think she got on mute for a second. Yes. Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm here. My phone died. You said by blue what?
If the man who was a 40-year-old virgin, he's a married, he's a millionaire, but... He blew.
No. Listen. Multi-millionaire dude, right? In your eyes, the perfect man. This the guy you've been looking for your whole life, right? You fuck with him and everything. Tough. Only thing he wants is that he wants to marry you and just have a baby. That's all he wants. But the only thing is, he's blue. Could you overlook that and fuck with him? Get married to him, have a baby?
What does blue mean?
His skin color is blue.
Like his skin color blue?
Yeah, the color blue. I love it for it.
Man, y'all crazy as hell.
Would you do it, Halo? Yes or no?
He blue. So that means my baby might come out blue?
It might come out purple.
He's coming out blue. Something's going to be blue. At that point, something's going to be blue.
It's coming out purple. Yeah.
Man, you got to think, because genetics come into perspective here. So, like, listen.
It's going to come out purple.
I don't know, a millionaire ain't enough. A billionaire maybe, but I mean, a million,
he got enough to take care of you and your family for the rest of your life.
A million ain't enough. I'm about to go buy a motherfucking blue morph suit.
But look. Check this out. He's the only blue man in the world. Nobody even knows this dude is around, that how he got his money or nothing. Nobody knows. But he's a rich dude. He found you and was like, "Hey, I want
to." You need to write a book now. You need to make that a fucking book, because at this point, how he get rich if don't nobody know he blue?
I'm just saying, you don't know this man. You don't know him from nothing.
Hey,
ran into him.
I swear, when this nigga brought this topic up, I said, "Yo, what in the fuck is wrong with you?"
Swaz,
right now?
Let me ask you this question. Hold on. Swaz, if a woman had two pussies, would you try to fuck both of them?
It's women out here with two pussies.
I understand that. That's what I'm asking. That's why I'm asking Swaz.
Like, cause my pussy it's split down the middle. I got a pussy on the right and a pussy on the left. But my pussy on the left ain't never been fucked.
Mm. Hold on, wait a minute. You got two pussies?
So she's still a virgin on the left side.
I'm a virgin on the left side.
No, Swan. So what I asked Anthron was, if you met a woman with two pussies and you was getting ready to fuck, and you tried to fuck the second one, and she said, "I'm saving myself for marriage. I'm saving that one for marriage." What would you do?
Oh, hold on. We gotta go back to something real quick. Halo, what did you just say about
two pussies? No, I'm coming
yeah, we're not gonna speed past this real quick. No.
I got two. Listen, it's like a pocket, right? It's like a wall. Like, so if a person goes straight in, if I have sex and he goes straight in, it's like a fucking wall. It's like I got two uteruses.
Oh man. Wait a minute. What?
You know, I told this earlier on the pod, I've had sex with a girl who had two pussies, and it's definitely different. It's definitely different.
Yeah, but my left pussy ain't never been fucked. Like my children came on my right. That's why I had to get a cesarean for both of my children. It's crazy. You feel what I'm saying? So, you know, it's blessed by the best. It's actually a blessing, though, to have it. You feel me? I ain't even going to hold y'all, because, you know, running into complications through life and things happening and stuff like that. So it's like, okay, well, if they take this one, I still got my left one.
So do you feel what I'm saying? Do you have two clits?
No, it's just one click. It's just one click. Mm-hmm. One click, one urethra, but vaginally, it's a hole with a hole, two holes.
Whoa.
Yeah, hers was on top of each other. It's one on top and one on the bottom right there.
Hello, so will you come to my live and tell this fucking story?
No, I'm not coming to your live and tell this shit to nobody. I never said this before, ever. I don't even send pussy pictures, and people be like, "Why you don't want to send me no pussy picture?" I'm like, "Because I got a complex. Like, all pussies like ugly." I'm like, "Nah, see, this is different. You feel me? Like you know, like it's so crazy because I was born with a twin sister. You feel what I'm saying?" So,
One second. I gotta do something real quick. Shout out to our listeners from Greece, Saudi Arabia, Norway, Iran, Japan, Brazil, Israel, Italy, Argentina, Switzerland. Shout out to you guys. I appreciate you guys supporting the pod, and I guarantee I'll still make great content moving forward. So shout out to you guys. Now let's get back to the conversation.
Yeah. Hello?
Yeah,
you're still here.
You're gonna be heard around the world.
Oh my God.
The
world don't bother me. But
we trying to get you out in the world, hello, all over the United Nations and all that shit.
Yeah, so like it's like, you know, it's it's been hard. Like for instance, like penetration. I'm not I don't like penetration at like I'm a head type of person, because like it just made me feel special. Head made me feel more special than penetration, because like you want to lick both of my pussies. Like, so.
I got a question for you. Cause when I was sleeping with old girl, when she told me about it before she came to see me, but when I actually slept with her, she wouldn't let me penetrate the other one. She only just let me penetrate one of them. Why is that?
Because it's like, I can't just be giving both my pussies away.
look, Halo. So look. If he do fuck both of them. Hold on. If he does fuck both of the pussies, is it considered a threesome?
That's double dipping, though. Like, that is.
That's what I'm saying, but though. That's two different pussies, though.
Yeah, that is two different coochies. I ain't gonna lie, but he not fucking both of them. This is one.
No, I'm saying if he does, though. If he hit one and then hit the other one.
That's basically, yeah, because it's two different pussies. It's on the same body, but it's like having Siamese twins, right? And one gay and one ain't. You feel me? But you gotta sit there and watch or feel your other part of your body get fucked, but you ain't gay.
I just that.
That went a lot left.
Yeah, that went very left for a second.
No, right. It'd be like that, though.
Nah, I feel you, but I just didn't expect you to say that you had one, though. Like, that wasn't the, that's what I
did. But no, expect. my left pussy never got fucked. And then it's dry, though. Like, I ain't gonna hold you. Like,
really?
It's like, it's dry. It's both the coochies dry. Maybe my left one get wet. I don't know. But the right one dry.
So yours is sideways. Hers was up and down. That was crazy to me.
Yeah, it's like it's one hole, but it's two sides.
Yeah. Yeah, that hers was up and down.
You have two different tunnels.
It's one hole, but it's two sides. It's like
split.
Yeah, you can see it's a split, yeah.
Wow. You got
some, and it's like a little wall right there. Like if you try to go straight, and if you were running to it, like dang, what is that?
So you got to go left at the fork in the road.
You got to go left, like that's why. Like see, that's why I be doing the thing with the banana, because I'm trying to attract men with the hooks, because the hook is helpful. You feel? Because it's like,
yo,
hello. I told you, I got you. Honey. I got you.
Yeah. Hello.
What's up?
I'm intrigued. Nigga. This has changed my entire perception of you.
Nigga.
To know that you're twice the fun, like you're already super fun. Like, double? You got double?
Too bad. You said too bad. By
no, and no, one never been touched, right? One never been touched.
One never been touched.
So you like half virgin.
Would you wrap a red bow on it for the right man?
Yeah, what am I saving it for the right person?
Yeah, would you put a red bow on it for the right man? Would you?
Yeah.
Would you? Do they have to marry?
I cut the ribbon. Yep.
They gotta marry you.
Huh?
They gotta marry you.
I would say so, but I don't know. I just don't know. I don't know yet. I don't know. I haven't met nobody that made me want to use my left pussy yet.
So hey, you're a half virgin.
Hey, Halo. I'm gonna play something real quick, and have you come into this trip?
You're tuned into the sound. What is this? I don't know what he's playing, but just listen to it's Anthony shooting the show.
Who is it?
Hey, we got Anthony shooting. Shout out to Halo. Shout out to Halo. Shout out to the Man Squad. Hey, my name is Mo. Suck it slow. Suck it slow.
Rockin', we don't stop. No handle, balls are falling off. Cause she ran me like a porn star.
She made me like a porn star.
What's crazy? You want to know what's crazy, though? Speaking of riding, like, you know how, like, all right, you guys are men, so you know the noises that women vaginas make when they ride.
Yeah.
Right? My pussy whistle.
Wait.
What?
When I ride dick, my pussy whistle.
What the fuck? What? Oh, the other one.
Yes, because of the air and the pressure. So it'd be like, it'd be a whistle. I don't even know how to whistle with my mouth, but it whistle. It's the funniest shit ever. I swear I can't ride for long because I'm going to start laughing because the motherfucker is going to whistle every time. Listen, like,
if y'all hear her, if Halo really comes to this trip, and y'all hear that shit in the room, y'all know what's going down. Y'all know
what's going
if y'all hear it, y'all know what
it was at this moment.
No, he asked a question. My thing was always this. You asked a question about a threesome, right? My thing was always this. Like, I've never been that girl. You know how girls go through their experience that had, you know, a train ran on them or they've been jumped or whatever. I don't know what they call it. I'm like, I wonder would that be considered the same if I was to do that, but it would be like one guy in one pussy and the other guy in the other pussy. Would that be considered me getting a train ran on me?
But it's the same hole, right?
It's just, yeah, but it's two different pussies.
But here's the issue with that, though. I'm not sure. I don't feel comfortable with that at all. Cause if it's the same hole, and then we gotta put our both of us gotta put our dick in that same hole. That's a no go for me.
And then I gotta hook two hair now. Every time I'm rubbing again. Nah.
Oh, you wanted me to know you had a hook?
No, this nigga, I just caught that. You what?
Get hooked up.
I don't got the.
Halo's used to people trying to slide. She know all about the slide, bro.
I don't got the hard hook though.
Oh no, she works on hearts. She's a cardiologist. You got you.
Hey, it's so crazy. Listen, it's so crazy that, but. No, I never did that because for that same reason, I never like that's just nasty for one. That's how bacteria, you know, all kind of stuff can happen with that. Because the biggest like germy organ on a woman body is her vagina. If you look up what type of host is needed for an infection, it needs to be dark, wet, and dark, wet, and fluidy. You feel me? And moisture, and I think warm. That's what it is. Dark, moisture, and warm. And what is a vagina? It's dark in the inside, it's warm, and it's moist. So it's always easy for bacteria to grow in that area. So at the moment, your bacteria and that person's bacteria from that body, because everybody body carry bacteria, if you release your bacteria in that and he releases his, that's why they get tricked so much and so fast. And that's why they say it comes from a woman. When you look it up and say it's carried by a woman, men cannot carry trick because nothing goes inside your hole. You get what I'm saying? So it's not a host for infections. But, you know, shorter story short, it's just like, I never been that person because I feel like y'all boss gonna rub up against each other. Then y'all be like, y'all swore fighting over the hole. Hey, that might be a good skit. Like, we're about to have a train, but y'all got a swore fight.
You heard it here first.
That is
like whoever go in first, like it's a swore fight. So they swore fight.
Yo, that is first. Oh, good
when
God!
When you make that skit, you like, definitely have to tag us in there.
Battle to the death.
You definitely have to tag us in that because we definitely you thought over here. This is where it happened.
That's funny.
Exposing that you had. Double tunnels in the floor.
Halo, I have a real question for you, and I've never asked you before. Have you ever slept with a man where your tongue was longer than his penis?
Yes.
Whoa.
Yes.
What?
Matter of fact, his name is Club Godzilla. He got a little ass dick, and he's a producer. Go by B-King.
Hey, hold on. I just want you to know that you do know this is going to be heard around the world.
I don't give a fuck. I'm not lying.
Hey, I was on the live when she announced this last time. Talk your shit, Halo.
Wow.
You were on Cut the Fuck Out right now. So
he got a little dick and I have to scoop ride it.
Oh, wow.
What's scoop ride?
It's when you can't let no air get between the woman's genital and the man's genital. Like no air, no none of that. It's all scoop riding.
So you basically you were trying. You were basically clit rubbing.
Basically,
yeah. scissors.
Set up for a yeast infection.
Hey, Halo, is it okay if I say this is actually just happened to you?
Huh? Emotional damage.
Nah, she not. Go ahead, talk your shit, Halo. What happened?
No, like, you know, I ain't gonna lie to y'all. You feel me? I suck this dick for some clout or whatever, but I ain't get my clout, so I'm telling everybody to know his dick is small.
Wow. Well,
give this woman her clout. God damn it. Give her a clout.
Give me my motherfucking clout. I don't give a fuck. I'd rather some out here doing it for a Birkin. I sucked dick before for a burger. But at the end of the day, like, I did this time because I wanted to a shout out. You feel me? Look, you were supposed to host a live review, music review and shit for me. You ain't keep your end of the bargain. So why do I got to keep my end of the bargain by staying quiet?
I'm gonna say this. I will definitely be adding tags to.
Oh, and I'm gonna be in Texas soon too. Oh my God, they might jump me.
I will tag everybody who's been on the podcast so far today. All this has been fucking crazy, but I will tag everybody in the description for the pod. I don't know even sure what the hell we're going to put. I'm going to put down as topics right now because this shit has been absolutely craziness. Swazi, you want to tell the people how to find you, man, what your Instagram is?
Yeah, Swazi.
Yes, certainly. You can find me on Instagram at SwaziTV. Catch me Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. Live on IG. I have plenty of guests. Halo, every now and again, we'll stop through. Wells included. Sometimes I'm blessed by the great host, Anthony. So please tune in whenever you have an opportunity. And please bring your good energy. I don't really got time for the weirdness.
All right. I'm definitely gonna link your bio in the description, man. Halo, shout out your comedy page again and your artist page.
That would be, the artist is Halo the Dominatrix. That's HALOTHEDOMINATRIX. Halo the Dominatrix as one word. You can find me on all streaming platforms and go stream. Oh, you Hoochie Daddy Shorts Anthem. You are talking to the originator, the one who made that word go global and why people are saying it across the nation. I started that. Yes, Hoochie Daddy. I did. Also, you can follow my comedy page at Halo Funny as Fuck with a PH, HALOPHUNNYASPHUCK. And that's on all platforms, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, hashtag Halo Funny as Fuck if you're looking for me, and you will find me everywhere. Big old Twitch, wherever you want to find me at, YouTube.
Halo, I forgot something really important. As you're speaking, and you're going to forget something important, I want you to catch up right after me. But the Angels, Swazi's Angels, much respect, ladies, to all of you. Thank you. And y'all can tap in with them at Swazi's Angels on Instagram as well.
All right. Thank you guys for being on the pod, man.
Shout out Swazi and Halo.
Yeah.
Oh, and why you ain't play my song?
Which one?
Hoochie Daddy Shorts.
Oh,
let she me got see. A catalog. Choose one at this point, Anthony. Which one you got? Hoochie Daddy Shorts is what that's what's out right there. That's what everybody's talking about.
All
right.
Well, yeah. Let me.
How do you? What other device you got over there? What you playing music off of over there?
On Apple Music.
Okay, so look up Halo the Dominatrix and Hoochie Daddy should pop up.
All right, I got you.
It's all one word. Halo the Dominatrix. HALOTHEDOMINATRIX.
I got it right here. That's where I'm gonna add it to it right now. I'm gonna play it while you're on here before I let y'all go. I'm gonna play it.
That's dope.
Hey, this is DJ Dick'em Down right now.
You that's the hospitality.
The fuck out podcast. I got my boy AC, aka Mr. Nasty Tom. I got my boy Swaz. I got Miss Halo, aka Watch the Bananas. Hey, this,
Watch the Bananas.
This is a single that y'all can find. It's called Hoochie Daddy Shorts. It's on all, it's streaming on all platforms. Y'all shout out to them. Y'all make sure y'all look them up. Follow them on IG. Follow them on everything.
I just downloaded it here. Let me pull it up here.
And again, to the haters and hoes.
Well, let's go. Let's
suck it slow.
Let's go real quick. Let's go.
All the fellas, can y'all do me a favor? Free your knees. Pull your shorts up right now.
Hey, show, you like to the
show me your knees, fellas.
Y'all in here. Y'all in these streets. If you in these streets, let's go. Come on. Man, I'm not doing take your camera. This nigga Wells right here. Dang, what the
let me see Wells, the knees.
Ever since Wells got them knees free, he don't know how to act.
That nigga
he been
right
out there kneecapping. He been out there kneecapping. Look, kneecapping like a mug.
Let's shout out to Halo. This is her drop. It's our new senior right here.
Daddy shorts on. They come right up for the knees. Need to see them thighs. We want to see them knees. Me and my bitch is checking. We looking for your peas. H-O-O-C-H-I-E. Daddy shorts on. They come right up. And they taste this poor. That print look good. Are them shorts deep or? Oh, he must
oh, he not hear
me. Or they could be a Mary. Fresh cut with the gray shorts. I need that nigga near me. It really do it for me. When his ones match, I'm on that nigga ass. Somebody get his ass. Catch me looking hard. Catch me looking aggressive. We slutting niggas out and leaving money.
Halo right there.
Shout out to Halo. Shout out to Swaz, man.
Much respect.
Y'all. I appreciate right, y'all.
Well, let's get into what I was going to say. The person who needs to shut the fuck up, Ted Cruz. Ted Cruz, please just stop talking. Nothing about anything you're saying makes any fucking sense whatsoever. So just do everybody a favor. Stop talking. And then we're going to get out of here the way that I always end the pod.
Appreciate it, Ezra. Appreciate it, AC. Shout out. Hey, y'all, follow me. Radio Wells, RADIO underscore Wells. You know what I'm talking about? Check out my live content on IG.
I thought we were gonna I was trying to keep it at 130, 145. Went a little over, but it was a great fucking episode. Shout out to Wells sitting in today. Shout out to everybody who came on the pod today. It was an absolutely crazy ass episode. Yeah. We're out of here. Hey, one